What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and I gotta talk about an artist who's taken a very unique path to his success. And not only that, he has this brand that will be seemingly everywhere, but conceptually, he was able to take it and package it into a strong, simple message. It's something that could be super helpful for not only a lot of artists, but anybody who has a brand that they have that they want to actually make impact with. Who is this artist? It's a guy by the name of Brandon Torrey. And just to give a little backstory, he was essentially an artist who was torn.
I was in my boss at Apple's office, and I was like, all right, you know what? Let me just come clean. I pulled up the video and I'm like, oh my, I don't know what he's gonna say. I've never told anybody in music that I'm an engineer or in engineering that I'm a musician. And he goes, oh my God, is that you? Is that Timbaland? Oh my God. My name is Brandon Torrey. I'm a senior software engineer at Google, and I'm also a musician.
But this is where the real struggle is, where a lot of people can relate, because the people who knew him in the music world, they had no idea that this guy was killing it at Apple being a senior architect. And the people at Apple had no idea that he was working with Timbaland, had no idea he was throwing parties, any of that stuff. It was literally a tale of two worlds. Until he was eventually tired of living these two separate lives and realized he had to bring these things together. And that's when he came up with the concept multi-dream. Now, if you follow Brandon Torrey, you'll realize that this brand is his ongoing brand in the same way someone like Nipsey Hussle has the marathon, right? It's his ongoing brand to express the idea that we can achieve more than one dream in a lifetime. Now, I think that's something that's pretty clear, because you've seen people like Arnold Schwarzenegger or people like Jay-Z or people who have done multiple successful things in their lifetime. They had a goal, they set that goal, they achieved it, and they kept going and achieved something else. But the thing is, especially in this space, when you're thinking about an engineer, right? Somebody who's coding, and then you're thinking about the creativity of an artist, for whatever reason, people have looked at them as these disparaging concepts, as if they cannot go together fluidly. He himself, in an article in Forbes, actually talked about this. And this is the part that's so important, because now we're talking about how he was able to package his message to a point where it made impact and it was communicated clearly. What he did was he created a documentary. Torrey said, I had a really big party in LA and shot footage so I can make a documentary and explain to people who I really was. I wanted them to know the distinction between science and creativity is no longer important. I think we can just be ourselves. That was my goal. This idea of creating a documentary alone is something that so many people have to use and realize that these documentaries are more than just something for people to watch and just have a lot of content for them to follow in a vlog style. It's literally a tool. It's your PR tool to get a message out. Too many people are just collecting footage and making compilations without actually thinking about a strategic message and the impact that you want to make when you put it out. What do you actually have to say? And for some people, that might be less of a documentary style footage of yourself. They might use other people. It depends on how you want to brand yourself. And in the Forbes article, he actually talks about how he sends this footage out to the people at Apple. He said, I made a 1 minute mock commercial for Apple that described this new generation of creators and scientists who no longer believe in the boundaries between science and creativity. And once again, you see this idea of science and creativity actually being able to be something that go together as opposed to being separate, which I completely agree with in the first place. I've never thought of them as separate. As a matter of fact, they collectively give life to each other and refine each other. Studying people like Albert Einstein, who obviously one of the GOAT scientists in the game, super well known, who so vehemently believes in the power of creativity, the necessity of creativity, will easily let you know that one without the other is underwhelming. Which brings me back to multi-dream. This is the biggest tool that so many people need to keep in mind when it comes to branding, right? One of the biggest problems that a lot of people have when it comes to branding and trying to get their message out is they keep trying to communicate these two seemingly disparaging ideas again and again. Yes, I'm this, but I'm that. Yes, I'm this, but I'm that. But what you're doing is digging yourself in a whole way you have to continuously explain yourself as opposed to simplifying your message. Multi-dream easily allows him not only to say, hey, I'm this and I'm that, But it also allows other people to fit themselves in to their own versions. I'm this, but I'm that. So what I'm saying here is a lot of times people have these concepts. They have all of these ideas or this brand they want to explain. However, they never take the time to simplify it. And the best thing you can do is find one word that already exists or a word that you actually create from scratch and give it a definition so it defines whatever these multiple facets of your brand is. Now, you don't have to explain yourself again and again. You just have to use the word and then make sure people understand the word. At the same time, you're creating brand equity. This is one of those weird things because oftentimes you guys hear me talk about diversity or when you're trying to do too many things at one time, and then you might say, well, how did this person do this? And they did that. And they did that. Well, we have some people who are doing one thing at a time, but then this is another concept where he's talking about doing these two things simultaneously and working on them simultaneously, not necessarily achieving one dream, then the other. However, he made two things become one by creating this one brand concept. So he's constantly working on this one concept. I hope that's clear and it doesn't go over people's head, but the thing that has to honestly be thought about is just the fact that simplicity is always going to be the key when it comes to branding. I know a lot of times people build this identity in complexity and I'm this and I'm that and I can't be understood, and they like to put the ownership on other people for not being able to understand you. However, you have to realize it's far easier to complicate things than it is to simplify things. Yes, there's some people who just don't have any substance, but when you have something of great substance, communicating that easily and sharing that message, passing that off, takes true work to simplify into something that could become spreadable, something that becomes viral, something that becomes useful. Complexity that hasn't been refined to the point that it's simple and functional is useless. And whenever I'm thinking about this subject, one quote always comes to mind, and that's this quote by Mark Twain. At least it's said that it's by Mark Twain because, you know, some of these quotes get misquoted over time. There's fake quotes. I don't know if you guys are aware of that. But anyway, Mark Twain said, "I don't have time to write a short letter, so I wrote a long one instead." You know what? I'm not even going to explain that quote. I would love to know you guys' thought on this subject, on that quote in itself. I want to see that discussion because I know a lot of people, they struggle with this stuff, right? It's hard to simplify your brand message and come into something useful. But hopefully it's something helpful for you guys to follow people like Brandon Torrey and see what he's doing. I definitely think he's a person worth following. Other than that, if you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button. If you like it, you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.